Oh.
Hello from the Hudson Lampoon. My name is Adriana and welcome to The Hot Seat. Today's episode is brought to you by Franny's in Highlands, New Jersey, where we ask hot questions and eat even hotter wings. Today we are joined by one of our history teachers and coaches, Mr. Patrick. While he may drive out on the golf courses, will these wings drive him crazy? So, how are you with spicy foods?
So, I am a little nervous. I'm excited. I've done no prep, but I think I'm just gonna go in and hope for the best.
I think you got it. All right, let's get started with our first wing, which is the classic chili maple edition. This way? All right. I'm just gonna do what I did last time. Okay.
And this, I'm not a big maple fan, like, but I don't know if just with the wing, it actually tastes very good.
There's not a lot of spice. I accidentally bit into the bone, but you know, it's okay.
Yeah, that's
I like
true.
It.
That's true.
It's very mild. Very mild.
Yes.
So, what inspired you to become a history teacher?
So, that's an interesting question. When I graduated high school, I knew I liked history. I loved learning history. It was my favorite subject. Unfortunately, Indiana Jones wasn't a major. So I figured education was the next best choice. Mm-hmm. And when I got to school, got to Rowan, was going through it, and then I said, there's no way I can teach history for 180 days straight. You know, I loved it, but I didn't think I could just teach content for 180 days. Luckily, I had an advisor that convinced me to stay with it and talked about all the other aspects of teaching. And through my course of, I'm glad I stuck with it because all those other things have come true. You know, making connections, helping students, and you know, just the conversations you have on a daily basis. And then one of the other things that kind of I always enjoy about this job, it's always a restart. Every year is a new start, a fresh start. So, you know, you're never doing the same thing over and over because every class itself is different. So I get to continue to learn the history and also make these connections. So it's been a good choice. Good thing I stayed.
Well, we are so grateful to have you here at Hudson.
Good.
All right, so our next wing is Bonji Ranch.
Okay.
Hate ranch.
So. Oh, I love ranch. So I think we're gonna be 2 for 2 so far.
Ew, I'm like, it smells foul.
Oh. Oh, the sunflower seed taste. Mm. That one's a little messy though. I can see a tray of that being real messy.
I really hate that.
Oh, I see. I like that a lot because it doesn't have the spice yet. So we're still good. We're still good. Not the crazy spice.
So, we know that sometimes, sorry, that was so bad. All right, so we know that sometimes being a basketball coach is hard, especially when you're teaching teenagers, Gen Z to be exact. Have you heard any funny phrases while you're coaching? Like for example, slay or beef?
Yeah, so slay is definitely one I heard a lot. You know, Shannon Kenny definitely brings that up a lot. I think what's funny to me is, you know, the warm-up in basketball, you know, me and Coach Dwingert are always doing our thing, talking, game plan, strategy. I don't know the amount of times, and I can't think of exact phrases, that I've just stopped mid-conversation because I'm listening to what the basketball team is speaking about or what the softball team is speaking about and just can't imagine what you guys, you know, are going through and what you're saying. If there is one that I do like, not that deep is one that I, you know, I don't know if I could put that in my vocabulary as a 33-year-old, but I do. That's gotta say, it's got my favorite one to this point.
Yeah, because you use like knucklehead a lot and
yes.
You use kiddo. Like, where did those come from?
I just guess the old man in me. I guess you're right, being, I mean, 33 old man with those phrases. Mm-hmm. Yeah, knucklehead. I guess it's my easy way of saying, like, pay attention and get it together. But yeah, those are kind of fun, lighthearted ways to get everybody's attention there.
All right, so let's get to our third wing, which is Cadejo.
Okay.
Cadejo?
It looks like a mean rabbit on the jar there.
Mm-hmm. Oh, mine's like a heart. Wait, this is so cute. Okay.
too.
It's kind of like...
2417.
It's not like the ranch, but I wouldn't say it's like in that buffalo family just yet there. I don't know what the flavor...
I can't describe
the flavor there.
It's kind of like lemony, sour.
That's a good call. Lemon. The lemon's a good call there.
Yeah. But while we're on the topic of being a coach, we are entering baseball and softball season. What has driven you to coach softball and not baseball? Because we know that softball carries Hudson.
So I played baseball my whole life. Loved baseball, still love the game of baseball. It's always been something big to me. When I started here, I was actually the middle school coach for 2 years. I enjoyed it. And then my third year, Mr. Feeney dropped out of softball and Mr. C needed an assistant, and we had just become kind of friendly working in the building, and he needed a new assistant coach, and he asked me to do it, and I was real nervous because I don't know softball like baseball. A lot of people think they're the same thing, but they are a little bit different. Mm-hmm. And I knew they had a really good team and I didn't want to mess anything up. And that year we made it pretty far and I got to fall in love with the game. It was a much quicker game than baseball, or if you're a baseball fan at all, it could be slow. Softball was real quick, real fast moving, and I just stuck with it, and now I am 8 years later still part of it. So yes. Kind of was a little hesitant at first, and now I've jumped right in and loved it.
Yes, well, I appreciate you as a coach. Our next wing is Los Calientes Verde.
Oh, I do like verde sauce. What we do with tacos when we do them.
I do so like this. I got a big wing. This is...
that is a big one there.
This is literally huge. Okay.
Yes, you could definitely taste that verde.
I think that one's good.
Yeah, actually very good.
Very good, yeah. And you know what? The verde kind of gives a nice little cooling to it. So it's not like, hot on the mouth there.
Oh no, I really like that. Okay, so sadly for some, especially you, Indiana Jones is not a major in college.
It is not.
But apparently you have claimed to be an expert on the Indiana Jones franchise, so I'm gonna quiz you.
I like Indiana Jones. I'm not gonna be good at this one here.
No, you got it, okay. What does Henry Jones Jr. call his son?
Skip?
No.
I'm in Korea.
All right. Where does Indiana Jones teach archaeology?
Ooh. I love watching these movies. This is a bad one. Is it out of school? No, I'm completely wrong.
It's out of school, yes, but what's the name of it?
I don't know. This is bad. This one's not good for me. I'm in big trouble
what
here.
What famous Raiders scene was cut short due to an actor's illness?
It wasn't the ball right when he's going to run through the bright mound. I think one of them got hurt doing that. I could be wrong. No, so I'm not sure.
Which Indiana Jones actress did Spielberg marry?
I do not know.
You would have failed out of
I would have failed
Indiana
out of
Indiana Jones
I
major.
Failed out of any, I just, that's what I mean. I just like the idea of Indiana Jones going to explore. Yes.
What is the movie called coming out this summer?
Oh, it is...
Come on. You've gotten zero.
I've gotten zero, yes. I've gotten zero. I'm not up to my Indiana Jones new movies. Harrison Ford's really the only... Yeah, I struggled with this one.
All right, well, Henry Jones Jr. calls his son Junior.
Makes sense.
Indiana Jones teaches archaeology at Marshall College. The scene that was cut short was him being confronted by a scimitar-wielding swordsman.
Okay.
Kat Capshaw plays Spielberg Mary. She did Spielberg Mary. And the movie coming out is Indiana Jones and the Dial of Destiny.
Well, there you go. I'll have to try to check the new one out there. And I'll try to maybe remember something about it for
Thank God you
my
did not go into Indiana Jones for college. Like, thank God. Next way is the Ghost Pepper Hot Sauce.
Ghost like the bottle on this one here. It's very interesting.
Do you see, like, I love these wings. They're really good.
All over the place.
Thank you, Franny's. They are so delicious. It's just my wing is very small.
Oh, it is good.
Kind of tastes like a burger.
A little bit of that taste to it there. A little bit of that taste. I like the bottle there. I don't know if they can see it, but it's almost got a little bit of a Mr. Bodnar look there to it.
Excuse me?
Oh, you don't have their faces on there.
Oh yeah, that looks like Mr. Bodnar a little bit. If he grew out his
the
hair.
Facial there.
So actually, we heard from a source that you are you have a passion and are skilled in botany.
I'm not sure. Who gave you this one here?
All right, let's just cut to the chase. Can you tell us about the time that you watered fake corn stalks?
Water, yes. So growing up, my family was not a Halloween, you know, we dressed up, we didn't do those things. So I didn't know anything about it. Me and my wife got married. We buy a house and she's all excited. Halloween's her favorite holiday. So she goes, we go to the field, we pick out all the corn stalks. Oh, this one's starting to hit me there. We pick up the corn stalks and it's been a couple days and I go to my wife, I'm like, do you need me to go out there and water their corn stalks? Like, do they need to stay fresh so they're good for Halloween? She asked me to repeat the question, which I should have probably taken as, don't ask that question again. Mm-hmm. But me being me, I did. I asked again. And to this day, she does not let me forget every year we bring corn stalks home that they do not need to be watered. So, I know.
Not only Indiana Jones.
Jones, I know.
Botany.
Botany. Crazy. Two categories out. Good thing, I guess, history teaching is my thing here.
Yeah. Maybe a little. So our next wing is the Mushroom Mayhem. We're on wing number 6.
Okay.
I'm actually excited for this one. I love mushrooms. This is a juicy wing. I think my taste buds are like dead. All tastes like burgers.
All like burgers. See, now I'm starting to feel it in there.
So coming from our new game,
I will say I'm at 6 though, so I'm gonna take this as a win so far.
You're doing good. So coming from our new game, Explain That Graham, we're going to show you some pictures.
Uh-oh.
And you're going to have to do your best to explain them.
Okay.
And the context and the events leading up to the photos.
Okay, okay.
So, number one, we have this one.
Oh, mean mugging days. So sometimes, you know, I like to say put your game face on. Clearly we can see the pitcher was probably a little nervous there with that face. And it probably explains why I was never a good hitter, you know, just awful form. Just awful form.
Your helmet seems to be falling off of
it.
What's going on there?
Well, clearly, right, I had the hat underneath, so it was definitely a bit of a struggle there. Oh.
All right, so our next photo. Our next photo.
Oh, this was Disney. So you, as one of my athletes, know I don't always have the best patience. You know, I like to get things moving. So we were in Disney. I was actually there with Miss Merrigan, couple other friends, Miss Ryan, and we were in the store, and I was clearly tired of being in the store. So I dressed up in my best Viking gear and started pushing everybody out, you know, because my words weren't enough, so I figured this would have scared them to get us moving.
Do you ever wish that you were a Viking?
You know what? I watched the show Vikings, love the show, don't know if I'm built for that lifestyle.
I think you would make a great Viking. Next one.
Halloween. So, yeah, so we needed a Halloween costume real quick, me and my cousin. And we needed something put together super quick. Our wives were dressing together, I forget as what. And we figured Lego pieces. So we actually got on the stage, I think, for like best duo. I don't think we won, but I think we got on the stage for
Did
it.
Did your guys' like Lego pieces like fit together?
No. No. The boxes themselves barely fit together.
Alright. Your next one. This is my favorite photo, because what is this?
This was I thought off limits.
I thought was off limits.
Oh, does this pain me? Does this pain me? So,
what is going on?
This one hurt. I don't know if I can come back to the building after this one. So, I don't know if this was 7th or 8th grade. I thought it looked good. Right? So, yeah. For all of you high schoolers now that think your looks are good, I'm gonna be honest with you. I woke up and thought this was good and was told this was good.
Hey, don't listen to him. You guys are doing great.
I'm just saying, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if you think you look good now, because you're gonna... Just do your thing. Do your thing, dress how you want, don't worry what others think, because I thought this was good. So, yeah, it was a bad look. Luckily, I grew out of that.
I can't tell if your hair is, like, greasy.
That might just be gel. That honestly might just be gel. And the crazy part with that is when me and my wife got married, our engagement party, she has a picture that's equally as bad, and we actually had a competition. People had to put a vote in the jar who had it worse. And I won for the worst one. Barely. But yeah, I thought that was off limits. Thought that was...
Is that the last one?
That's it.
Yeah.
I hope it's the last one. If anything out there is worse than that one, then I'd be in big
trouble. I got help by a lot of people.
I believe that was probably a top one.
There were a few other pictures I can.
Well, none I can imagine worse than that. That, to this day, yes. I think my parents actually have that up in the house somewhere, too. So I never will outlive that one.
Yeah. So, all right.
Might have to take a personal day tomorrow after that one.
Most def. I would, too. Our 7th wing is Dreams of Calypso.
All right.
It's yellow.
A lot of yellow in this set here. I feel like there was a lot of... All right.
Ooh. Ooh. Oh, my God.
Ooh. That spice comes quick on that one.
I don't know what I just bit into.
Yeah, I don't... It doesn't have that buffalo... Yet that buffalo taste to, like, any of these. But... That one hits you right away. It makes you, it dries you out quick. Oh.
Woo. Since you seem to be struggling,
right.
We've got an inside scoop that your favorite beverage is salt water. So I have some.
Oh my God. Yes. Oh.
I do have some. From the ocean.
From the ocean, yes. Now this one doesn't make me sound the greatest, just like the corn stalks, but can I tell a story behind this one? Where can I go?
Well, yeah, word on the street is when you got your wisdom teeth removed, you thought that the water from the salt water from the ocean would help cure your wisdom teeth pain.
Yes, yes. So see, this one shouldn't count again. Not my best moment. So I went in to get my wisdom teeth removed. I don't think I've ever been under anesthesia before that. So I came out, and it was actually, I'll tell the second part to that story, because now that we're deep in it, might as well just keep going. So that it started with the salt water. Oh my God, feeling this one. Woo! Woo! Thank God, my daughter just started drinking milk, so I got back into milk a little bit, so it's helping. But, so they had talked about drinking water, keeping their mouth clean. And I this is not mine because I don't remember, this wasn't something I said, but I guess I told the doctor that on the way home, we'll just stop. We drive by the Atlantic Ocean on the way home. Mm-hmm. I could just stop and get some if we need more. I also, and this is, makes us, yes, please. Ooh. Makes this even better. So they have all the gauze in your mouth, everything's in your mouth there. And I start asking my wife, who dropped me off, for my pack of cigarettes, because I want to smoke on the way home. And the doctor goes, you know, he really shouldn't do that. He's got everything, all these open wounds and cuts in his mouth. I've never smoked a day in my life, never had a cigarette a day in my life, and kept demanding that my wife pull over and get me my smokes. and my
you know, the doctor, when we left, is telling my wife, please, like, he can't, for the next 48 to 72 hours, have a cigarette. And she goes, he's never had one, so I don't know why we're going to start now. She said, I got a little angry on the car ride home. Again, I don't remember, but that I really, really wanted them. To the point she was tempted to buy me a pack of candy cigarettes.
Aww.
Which I used to put down a lot as a kid, but that's the closest I ever got to smoking. So it kind of was funny that I promised that I would have salt water from the ocean and my cigarettes. I had neither, so my wisdom teeth ended up being okay. Cigarette. There you go. That would be a good one there.
Wisdom teeth causes you to smoke, but...
Causes me, yeah. I never... My wife had to tell me. I didn't believe her. Should have filmed that one. Probably could have made a couple bucks off of YouTube, right? Oh, man. It's first seven. These last three look like the biggest lings I've ever seen in my life.
That one was, like, it hit.
And it dried you out. Like, I felt like I had a lot of, like...
Really?
Yeah, I don't know.
It's with my lips.
Yeah, I don't feel my lips. So, probably not a good sign. Probably not a good sign.
So, we are actually on our eighth wing.
Ugh. Oh, this is the one.
So, we are on our eighth wing, which is also known as the bomb.
Okay.
So, good luck.
Try not to remember, don't touch your face.
I'm still not over the last one.
I'm nor am I. But I gotta do it. Gotta do it. Everybody else did 10. I'm gonna do 10. Woo!
Make your wife, make your daughter proud.
Yes. That's what I mean. If my daughter sees this, I don't want her to, you know, be moving through YouTube one day and say my dad couldn't finish his wings. Okay.
So.
Okay. Oh, yep, there it comes. Oh, there it comes.
Hearing that you're a checkers champion,
I
challenge you.
We got a positive story.
I challenge you to a game of speed checkers.
Speed check, love it. Must jump, right?
So, we're gonna play speed checkers. Ready? Checkers. All right. Oh, so can you? Hold on.
Woo!
Sorry. I don't know how to. All right. Can you tell us about the time that your friends brought a pitch counter to your golf and you failed so bad?
Oh, yes.
Because you were so bad and under pressure.
So, I like to golf. And by I like to golf doesn't mean I'm good at it. But I like to. And I promised my friends I was getting better. And they brought the pitch counter. And I clearly wasn't getting better. There was a lot of taps that day.
I think I'm struggling. Oh my god.
Oh, these wings have definitely ruined my focus. Oh.
I'll just take one. Oh, okay.
Give me a king. I'll just take one of my pieces. I don't want to beat you too bad.
Are you good at golf? Would you consider yourself, like, really good?
Not by any means. But.
Yo.
I like to play.
Yeah, I can tell.
So, I'm trying to, you know, I've gotten a little bit more consistent. By consistent, you can do it. For you, I'll let you do it. I only got two pieces left. Go ahead, break the rules.
How did you become a checkers champion?
You know, third and fourth grade, when I was younger, you just used to play checkers a lot. In third and fourth grade, we had tournaments at lunch. And we had a teacher set up a big tournament one day.
And you won.
And I won both fourth and fifth grade year.
You have won.
I'm a happy guy. I did it quick.
Bringing back that checkers champion.
That we did. I did that all. I don't even think I'm focused on checkers.
The ninth wing, which is taco vibes only. And it looks tasty.
It sounds great, but I'm looking at the meter. It's not for a friend.
Really? 638,000.
I'm taking a nibble.
That smells strong.
I want to document that I took a bite.
All right.
That's all I ask. That's all I ask. Oh.
Emily said this was good.
I'm sure it is when you can, when it's your first bite and you're already not burning.
So, do you know anything about your long distance relatives, heritage, etc.?
So I do know my family came over, my dad's side of the family came over from like Czechoslovakia. But that's about like it. And the I have a last name, Patrick, and you would think like, you know, Irish, but not the least bit Irish. Mm-hmm. So those are really the two.
Well, we actually got a hold of your ancestry.
Uh-oh.
And I really want you to open this because I think you would benefit a lot from it, just knowing your background. So if you may. Huh.
Did you guys like try to get me? Like get...
Whew. Someone right up in.
Piece of paper.
Yeah.
40% cousins with
Danica Patrick.
Oh my god.
It is now revealed that you are 40% related to Danica Patrick.
So, weird story. I don't know if you know the story. Okay. So my dad, you know, I always used to watch ESPN growing up, and there was a story of a race car driver, Danica Patrick, and my dad said, oh, we're related to her. I was like, that's the coolest thing. I'm related to a famous athlete, like a NASCAR driver. Went to school for weeks, told my friends.
Well, didn't you have a big crush on her?
I did. Well, I mean, I thought she was a very talented driver. Thought she was very talented and was told, hey, told my friends and all and stuff like that. My dad ends up telling me we are not related, so made up a big story there that we were related to Danica Patrick there.
So you had a crush on your, so you thought cousin?
Well, not until after she wasn't my cousin anymore. Once I found out she wasn't my cousin, I was like, oh, you know, she's kind of cute. But yes, in elementary school, I thought Danica Patrick, but as I got older, realized we were not related to Danica Patrick, and she's a good-looking girl. She dated Aaron Rodgers for a bit, you know, was quite famous there.
Mm-hmm.
So, but yeah, no, not in the beginning, I thought we were just closely, you know, I thought we were related, I thought it was really cool. And then as you get older, get into your, I guess, formidable teenage years, you know, realize that we're not related, so it's okay to think Danica Patrick's attractive. So. Oh, this. Oh.
We have a tradition here on the hot seat where we add a last stab to our last wing. So.
We'll have to stick with tradition.
Are you up for the challenge?
I have to. I made it this far.
Right.
At this point.
Oh my, there's a chicken in my ear.
Great editing here.
So he's going for it? Yeah, you got it.
I just put the dab.
You should have a moment.
I'm trying.
Oh, I hate the last dab. Oh. I always end up putting too much. It's... Oh, God. Guys, I'm scared. Wait for me.
Okay. This is it, though. And then I eat 10.
I'm scared. No!
Wings are my favorite food, and I legitimately don't think I'll be able to eat them.
Oh,
wow. Like,
they're ruined. Just, they're...
Oh.
All right.
Wait, can I get my water ready for the... Mm-hmm. Am I going to get a record for the quickest to get the pitcher completed?
Can I take a little bit off?
No, we're in it.
No.
Do we cheers on the last one?
Okay, let's do cheers.
Cheers on the last one.
All right. Ready? Hurry. Okay.
Oh.
My mouth is gonna wet.
I just have no feeling. So it could be burning everything on the inside of my body.
It's just bad.
I'm sure it's just, like...
Oh! There's literally no way someone sits down and they're like...
Yeah, like, who sits...
Oh my god. I want this on my wings. No, you're a... Like, psychopaths.
That's what I mean, like...
Thank you for joining us today on the Hot Seat. Next week will be Mr. Lynch, so cool. We'll see you then.
Thank you.